ever in doubt?
Oh, hugely in doubt, wouldn't it? Hugely in doubt. I mean, to be fair to Bath, well, Bath are very good for, what, 50, 55 minutes. Way more at the races physically than we were. I thought their attitude to do everything was just at a level above ours, and we struggled with that. You know, we lost ball in contact. They managed to break tackles pretty regularly. Rocco Degouni was almost unplayable, to be fair. You know, I remember turning to Ali at one stage and saying it was like our Harry Potter had given him his cloak of invisibility at one stage. We were almost laughing about it because we couldn't lay a finger on him. But the truth was, you know, the only thing we talked about at halftime was nothing tactical, nothing technical. It was just all about attitude. You know, you can't come away from home in a top four contest and lose the physical battle. You know, you just can't. And we were losing everywhere. You know, our line-out didn't particularly function. Our scrum wasn't doing anything particularly. We struggled to get goal forward in our carrying. We were on the back foot often when they carried. You know, Dave Atwood's break up the middle of the pitch, I think, is a classic example. You know, Bath run the big front five forwards up the middle. It's a key momentum area for them. It's one you've got to target if you want to stop them. And, you know, he strode through us. And as I said, you know, they found momentum so much easier than we did. I thought their kicking game and their willingness to chase and compete was just, again, a little bit of a level above ours. And I think all you really saw was probably after that key moment in the second half when we were camped in our corner and we managed to resist a drive and then resist some phase play, and then we came up with a penalty. I think from that moment we actually looked pretty, I know it sounds a bit strange, we almost looked comfortable as a team from that moment, because then the whole momentum shifted our way. You know, all of a sudden Jack Noel is the guy making the breaks and getting us on the front foot. You know, Luke Carandicky, you know, is driving us forward. You know, I thought our front row drove us forward really well in the carrying game. We looked a lot more comfortable in everything we did. Our scrum started to become dominant. You know, our line-out became a lot more productive. And all of a sudden, just all the key elements that you have to come up with were just there. You know, Phil Dolman started plucking balls out of the air instead of Bath plucking them out of the air. And we got on the front foot, and what did we do? We produced two try-scoring opportunities and converted them both. And ultimately, it was just, I've got to congratulate the players, because it was massively down to attitude in the second half. But the question we've got to ask ourselves on Monday is, you know, how wasn't it there in the initial part of the game? Because you guys watched the game, Bath were in total control of that game at halftime, total control of that game. And we had to do something to shift that, and to great credit to the players, they did.
I mean, had Rocco Degouni gone over that first half.
I think just after half time, he goes in there. Like I say, Jack Noel scrambles, Phil finishes him off, and then we don't exit very well, but we still deal with that period of pressure and end up winning the penalty. And I think we went penalty, line out, won the line out, penalty, line out, and all of a sudden the pressure just shifted our way. And I said, we always said about half time, let's get within seven. As soon as we get within seven, we'll start to put pressure on Bath. You know, it's always the same, everyone sees it. You know, you're 11 points up or 12 points up, then all of a sudden you're within seven and the pressure just shifts. And that's what you saw today. I think we got the penalty, we got the try, penalty, everything shifted our way, and all of a sudden, you know, Bath were on the back foot defending, trying not to give up pens, and you can just see the momentum change it makes.
Rob, I know that the first hour wasn't a good feed, but you must be thrilled with the last 3-4 results.
I think if I was going to wrap it up, our season, if you look at our season, say in quarters, if you look at the first quarter, we didn't achieve what we achieved last year in a good season, and then you flip that on its head in the second quarter of our games, particularly in the Premiership. And if you look, we've won away at Sale, which we didn't do last year in a good season. We've taken 5 points against Leicester at home, which we didn't do last season. We got 4, and we've come to Bath and won, which we didn't do last season either. And we, you know, as I said, we had a good season last year, and so we actually started to knock off some markers that actually, in a way, could define an improvement on last year. Now, ultimately, we're not in a better position in the table, but we're knocking things off that were challenges for us last year, and I think that's as good a marker of where we're heading and where we're going and what we want to achieve as anything. You know, because ultimately, if we ever want to win this thing, we've also got to achieve something we didn't achieve last year, which is winning a final. You know, and for me, the key thing now is that if we want to be in a final again this year, it is now in our hands. You know, we don't have to rely on another team losing. If we keep winning our games, we'll stay in the top four. If you're in the top four, you get the opportunity to win your way to the final, don't you? And that's what we've been really driving, is getting the season back in our hands. We've done that now, and now our challenge is to make sure no one can take it off us.
What about that offload from Gareth Steenson to Tillerwinden?
Yeah, well, completely instinctive, wasn't it? The ball squirts out the side. At the moment the ball squirts out, as a coach, you think you've lost your opportunity, and then bang, in the next second, James Short's, you know, flying over. It's a little bit the same with Luke Carandicke's offload. You know, George Ford has stripped him in all intents and purposes. The ball's bounced free, and he manages to hook it back to Shorty. And you know, there are moments when you've got pressure that happen. I think that was the key for us. We didn't have any periods of pressure really in the first half, and we did in the second half. And once you've got moments of pressure and you've got a team on the back foot, things can happen.
And it's revenge for the 8th minute of injury time defeat in October.
Yeah, I mean, the truth is it couldn't be a flip result of what happened at our place, much closer than it was today. You know, my emotions are probably exactly what Todd Blackadder felt then, when he may be thinking that they're not quite going to do it and not quite see it off, and they do, and probably that's what we were thinking. You know, especially with probably still 15 minutes to go, the scoreboard's still looking against us. But then, like I said, you know, great credit to the players, because if you stay in the fight, especially if you can win the opposition 22, you know, you've got an opportunity.
Talking about knocking milestones off, this is first Premiership win here. How important is that? I know you mentioned it.
I think it's a little bit like anything, isn't it? As a team, I want us to move on from this, because it feels like it's all we've talked about in our Premiership history, and rightly so, that, you know, every week we're going to go out and we're going to try to achieve something new. But the reality of where we are as a club now is we were in a Premiership final last year, and if you get to a Premiership final, your aims and your ambitions shouldn't be about going to win a bath for the first time, should they, really? That's the problem. And I'm glad we've got it, we've knocked it off now, because we've got to be looking beyond just, oh, let's go and try and have a win a bath, let's try and win here, let's try and win there. Where we haven't won. You know, we've got to be talking now about what does it take for us to win the whole competition. Now, I'm not saying I think it's there on our hands now. It might take this year, it might be next year, it might be, but unless we start talking about what we're going to do to win the thing and stop talking about nice little milestones, we're never going to get anywhere. And I want us to move beyond being a milestone club that's just achieving something new in its history. I want us to push beyond that, and I think that's the mentality shift we have to make. Okay, great.